We would now like to start the explanation for the infrastructure the system business. The speaker will be Mr. Kunizo Sakai, CEO of Infrastructure System Company, and Mr. Aoki, who is the CEO of the Industrial Products Company. Please. Now, my name is Sakai. I'm going to talk about the first half of the infrastructure system company. And after that, Mr. Aoki will be talking about the industrial products company. Now, first of all, I'd like to talk about the positioning of the infra system company. We are belonging to the social infrastructure and information, telecommunication, and component is what we are providing, and also to the social infrastructure. Infrastructure business is also included. And 790 billion is the size of the business. Let me talk about the business activities and the portfolio. Now, we are aiming to become the best solution partner for the global customers' solutions management issues, and we have also consolidated the industrial area. And for May, an industrial products company was established as well. Component business will be expanded globally. We have set up the organization in order to enable this. And we have also the water environment solutions, industrial solutions plant, and also the industrial products are supporting the aforementioned two businesses. This is the business portfolio of our company. Now, let me talk about the initiatives for 2015. For 2015, or rather 2014, results will be explained. Sales was 790.9 billion yen, slightly below the last IR guidance. We had a slight downward revision. In terms of operating profit margin, 3.1%. This is a decline because of the reduction in revenues. As mentioned here, domestically, the businesses were such that we were able to increase revenues, but oil and gas, which is a global business, the market has had an impact on our business. For emerging countries, a slowdown in the economy has also impacted our business, and that is the reason why revenue was down. As a result, for the construction products in the Middle East, the profitability was deteriorated, resulting in these numbers. For 2015, on the other hand, revenues is 816.7 billion yen. When we had the IR meeting before, this is a downward revision of 142.4 billion yen, and operating profit margin is 5.0%. And this is also a downward revision from what we have announced previously by 1.9 percentage points. Now, in terms of the revenues, we have been impacted by the reduction in orders from overseas. And for the Middle East projects, we are going through a process of strict selection. And because of the weak yen, Japanese companies' overseas expansion has been curtailed. This is also having an impact on our business. For 2015, we have been hoping to see a significant increase in oil and gas. However, the market has deteriorated for this area. This is also having an impact on our business. Now, in terms of measures for 2015, revenues are not growing. We cannot expect high growth in revenue. Therefore, basically, we are emphasizing profit so that we can change our structure to poise ourselves for the next phase of growth. For 2014, 24.7 billion was the profitability. And for 2015, we are aiming for 41 billion. We will convert the business portfolio and also expand the product revenues in order to improve the profitability. We will continue and strengthen the STP to optimize cost structure. 8.3 billion and 8 billion will be the benefit from these activities. In terms of improving our profitability, we will convert the business portfolio and expand the product revenues. This is the result for 2014, as well as the forecast for fiscal year 2015. In particular, we will provide value-added services to solve customer issues in terms of water supply and sewage, also provide support to Japanese companies with business overseas. We shall also ensure profits are reaped from existing project orders. Especially for the emphasis will be placed on biopharmaceutical plants. So far, there have been some variance, significant variance for overseas projects. Therefore, we will strengthen the response to risky projects further than before. In terms of industrial products, below, high efficiency and energy conservation are prevailing needs. Furthermore, traceability and safety are important needs as well. We will introduce new products in a timely basis to growth markets. Furthermore, we also have the we're working with the Hitachi Industrial Equipment System for small and medium-sized components. We will strengthen the sales and service structure together with this entity. Next, I would like to talk about the optimization of cost structure. First is the continuous promotion of cost structure reform. As mentioned in this graph here, the supply chain enhancement will be made, and the variable cost ratio will be reduced. And we will also concentrate resources and accelerate management through business structure reforms. In October 2013, HBC, a company, was established for construction. In April of last year, HBS enhancement has been made in terms of reorganization. We will enhance operation efficiency together with these affiliated companies. We will also strengthen the individual products as well. As I mentioned earlier, in May 1st, the industrial products company was established anew. We will be promoting business on a global basis. In terms of cash flow management, for CCC, for 2015, there have been Middle East projects which has impaired the CCC somewhat. But seamlessly improving the efficiency of business process end-to-end, ranging from quotations to services, as well as a review of projects, should make improvements in terms of CCC. For 2018, we are aiming for 80 days. As for cash flow, Since we are working in the infrastructure projects, the one order is a significant amount. It must be controlled by project. Therefore, by project as well as by organization, cash flow management will have to be established. We are making preparations. It should be ready by 2016. In terms of the SDP, 2015 forecast is 8 billion in terms of benefit from SDP. Next, I'd like to talk about the mid to long-term strategy for growth. Market trends. Currently, for oil and gas, market is slow, is declining. The so-called developing countries' economic activities are said to have slowed down. Taking these factors into consideration, we believe that this is a long-term trend. Infrastructure market is slowing down temporarily, but however, we believe that in the medium to long-term future, the market should recover. Oil and gas and mining, energy-related, in these areas, production volume is to increase. These are the significant issues for this industry. For manufacturing, safety is very important, inclusive of food safety as well. This is the prevailing needs that are likely to increase. Centering on water for utilities, economic growth, and with the population increase, these two are inseparable. Therefore, we believe that this business will not shrink going forward. IoT will enable this in a steadfast manner. To relate this to business development is an important management challenge for us. Next, I'd like to talk about the competitive environment. The vertical axis is the operating income ratio, and the horizontal axis is revenue. Absolute numbers are presented. As you can see, the left-hand top group, this is the companies that were early to change their business portfolio, and they are focusing efforts on their core business. On the other hand, the group on the right are focused on solution in terms of business promotion. This is a representative plot of these companies. Hitachi's strength resides in the middle of these two groups, especially in the area of IT as well as control system. Equipment and products are both available to Hitachi. We have a good platform in terms of providing solutions. This is the strength of Hitachi. Whether it be chemicals or whether it be industry, leading companies, collaborative creation is underway with Hitachi. In terms of R&D, AI as well as data analytics have been captured by Hitachi. This is also a major strength of Hitachi. In terms of the medium to long-term strategy for growth, we are aiming to become the global major player in the social industrial infrastructure market. We must provide solutions for customers. So we will be focused on solution and also strong products. By combining the two, we will promote our business into the future. In terms of solution business as well as industrial products business, we In these areas, we must allocate resources to the growing areas. One area is resource, and the other is life and security. And next is the social infrastructure, as well as the base business. We must grow our business in all these areas. In terms of collaborative creation with customers, as well as strengthening IT control and products, as well as operation know-how must be brought to bear in developing a business. As for products, on the other hand, we have established an independent industrial products company. By so doing, expeditious decision-making will be enabled. And product strength as well as development capabilities will be enhanced. By 2018, revenues of 1 trillion yen and operating profit margin of 8% have been set as goals. This is a diagram showing our strategy to enhance our competitiveness. Now, we must bring to bear our strengths in terms of IT control and products, resources, life and security, and core business and social infrastructure market. Social infrastructure are the markets that we have classified. It is important to grow close to the customers. That is going to be very important in terms of collaborative creation with the customers. We will provide total solutions, industrial solutions, as well as water and solutions. The technical group will provide support. Energy management is very important, water, as well as construction is important. It is essential in terms of infrastructure business. We want to have a horizontal across the group effort made to pursue this business. To support this activity, we will have an information and control platform improved. And the IT platform big data analysis will also support this effort. In terms of strategy, we will create new business by collaborative creation with customers, provide total solutions. Third, water, EPC, and the solutions will be promoted on a multi-pronged way, and also sell products where we are strong. By so doing, we intend to enhance and expand our infrastructure business. And next is solutions business. I will give you examples in this area as well. First of all, in terms of creating new business through collaborative creation with customers, I would like to emphasize that customers are beset with the need to improve their business and manage the with acceleration global supply chain, improving productivity and quality, as well as new products and new services. These are the issues besetting customers. And on the part of Hitachi, we'll support this in the area of control, IT, and manufacturing, and R&D. That is the organization that we would like to leverage. Please look at the diagram below. This is what we are deploying in one of our plants at Hitachi. Left-hand side is a sense. Through sensing, we will obtain information about the front, the plant operation site, and then it will go to think on the right-hand side. In the case of plants, energy efficiency improvement may be the issue, or lead time reduction may be the issue. So, we will provide a solution by providing data analysis to resolve these management, inclusive of the simulations. When executed, the control will become important for It will lead to control as well as work instructions where people are involved. This is a cycle we have established in our plant. Based on this example of Hitachi, we will be working, bringing to bear all these components together in the form of symbiotic autonomous decentralized platform to provide solutions to our customers. Let me talk about pharmaceuticals, which is a growth field for us. Currently, in terms of biopharmaceutical drugs are being developed. With respect to how Hitachi can provide support, please look below. We can provide the plant construction. From 2000, 60 biopharmaceutical production lines have been constructed. This is a track record we have already. And we also have the HIT Pharmas, which is a pharmaceutical manufacturing management system that we are providing. This is being promoted globally. In line with this, we will also bring to bear our abilities in terms of big data analysis. Currently, for certain pharmaceutical companies, we are working together in discussions about the utilization of big data analysis. Next is mining. Now, mining is an area where resources must be secured. This is an important focus for the mining industry, for mines, for iron ore, steel mills. Will mean that there needs to be logistics to transport the iron ore. There has to be utilization of IT to manage the iron ore as well. Various systems are required. And on our part, we would like to focus on the overall optimization of management to as well as productivity and quality improvement, as well as operational efficiency improvement as well. Operation cost reduction is also a major solution that we can provide, inclusive of maintenance. Total management will be provided in the area of mining. This is what we are aspiring to realize. Social Innovation Headquarters are working together with us. So that and the infrastructure system company is the execution team to promote this business. Now, multi-pronged development of core technologies and solutions into growth markets. The example given here is the water environment. This will include water and sewage, water production, recycled water are receiving focus. However, water is having a major contribution for industrial systems as well. We are involved in water and sewage and water production, recycled water, as well as operations. These are existing business for us. And we are also expanding our share in the larger government field products. We will now develop our business into the industrial field as well. Small-scale seawater desalination, as well as oil and gas water treatment are being planned. In particular, for the small-scale seawater desalination in the tropical zone for resort areas, the business is promising. High-quality water is requested for these needs. Inclusive of technology, we would like to deploy our business for such applications. Last year, in Singapore, for a resort area, we have acquired a water company focusing in this area. In terms of oil and gas, when these resources are extracted, water is essential. And dealing with the wastewater is an issue as well. We are not going to be focused on the oil area of the oil and gas business, but rather contribute to this industry in terms of water treatment. This is what we are studying at the moment, in particular in the United States. Specific projects are being promoted. We are making efforts to realize this project in the United States. In terms of water, I'm sure you are wondering about how we are developing our business overseas. Please look at the map here. In the United States, California was subject to drought. We are now developing our business not only in the emerging countries, but also in major countries such as the United States. There is also the focus on ODA projects as well. There's a country called Cabo Verde, and also in the Ukraine. These are the countries in which we will be promoting ODA projects. Major projects are underway. Next, industrial products business will be explained by Mr. Aoki. From 1st of May, the industrial products company has been established. Also, I am in charge of the Hitachi Industrial Equipment System Company as well. I would like to, first of all, talk about the objective of establishing this company. In a nutshell, to provide support to the social innovation business, product business must be strengthened in the industry area. We want to establish an industrial field where products alone can be competitive, business framework that generates stable earnings and cash, and provide core products that support the solutions and service businesses. We have set up a new organization to achieve this goal. Within Hitachi Limited, we have the Infrastructure System Company. For the larger compressors as well as pumps and high and mid-voltage inverters, as well as the power electronics motor of the power system and power distribution control devices, have been reorganized into the newly established industrial products company. From the Hitachi, we are working together with Hitachi Industrial Equipment System that are focused in the medium to small components. By working together, we'll provide solutions to the growing market. That is the purpose of this reorganization. Now, let me talk about the industrial products business activities as well as the portfolio. Industrial products as well as Hitachi Industrial Systems business domains are shown here. This can be categorized into three areas. One is the drive and automation. Second is the power supply and power transmission. Third is machinery. Based on these categories, as you can see above, we will be focused on developing strong products that meet a wide range of industrial needs. Now I'd like to talk about the overall strategy. First and foremost, to bolster global competitiveness by unified operation of products business from small to large, integrated business strategy will be developed. We will also prioritize strategic investment and resource allocation as a basic policy. In terms of enhancement initiatives, strengthen product lineups that suit a wide range of markets, prioritize R&D strategy, strengthen common platform technologies, optimize global manufacturing bases, unify the development of global sales and services, formulate alliance strategies from total business viewpoint. Now, this is by product field. At the very top, in the area of drive and automation, unified business development of high and low voltage products in terms of sales, services, and manufacturing. By so doing, we will obtain a superior position in global markets. For the power supply and power transmission, develop a business centered on outstanding technologies such as amorphous transformers to expand the business for the Asian industrial markets. Third, in terms of machinery, expand business through two-pronged strategies that combine organic approach and alliances to become a world-leading group. For 2018, we have 500 billion. We have a very high target for 2018, revenues of 500 billion yen and operating income ratio of double digit. Back to Mr. Sakai. Let me conclude. This is the business performance trends. For 2015, in terms of there has been business portfolio changes as well as product revenue increase has led to a profitability increase. And by so doing, we will be emphasizing profit margin so that we can transform the organization to be poised for the next growth stage. Now, we will become the best solution partner for meeting management issues of global customers and aim to achieve 813.6 billion yen in terms of revenue and 29.1% in terms of overseas ratio and operating profit margin of 5.3% in 2015. Mr. Watanabe will also be joining in the QA period. The floor is now open for questions. Question. I have two questions. First question is regarding the infrastructure system operating profit margin of 8%. This is your target. What will be the gross margin and SG&A ratio when this is achieved? So it's very difficult to compare against a company that only has EPC. But I would like to get a general understanding what kind of gross margin can be generated from projects and what will be the SG&A cost base. In terms of a target of 8%, I'm sure there is a preemptive investment as well. There are also development projects as well, which could be a loss-making. I'm sure that this is also taken into consideration. So how much of these types of projects are included in the 8% calculation? That's the first question. Answer. For 2018, the detailed numbers have not been decided yet. In terms of ratios, half is components, and the other half will be solutions inclusive of EPC. That is our assumption. Against this backdrop, in terms of profitability for products, disclosure has been made. 10% will be the target. Overall, the target is 8%. For solutions, in fact, the high target has been set. Total target is 8%. In terms of the substance or reality, according to what we are considering in terms of the fixed cost as well as the variable cost taken into consideration to achieve the target, 30% plus the fixed cost reduction will have to be reduced by 30%. And in terms of variable cost, a 50% plus reduction will have to be realized to enhance efficiency. A cost reduction will have to be made in an efficient manner. That is how we are proceeding. However, we cannot disclose specific numbers. Question, second question, regarding industrial products company, drive automation and machinery is a major classification. It seems that machinery is at the closest level to the top group globally. I understand that you are aiming to join the top group, but drive automation is something for the future. It seems that you would like to establish a global position prior to this. In terms of compressors, I don't know what your definition for top group is, but on an individual basis, please talk about the global share you have. What is the positioning today? And what is your target going forward? Siemens have made an acquisition. And it doesn't seem that there are many other companies that can be acquired. But you said that the alliance will be promoted in terms of your strategy. What is your intention in this regard, inclusive of alliance as well as acquisitions? What is your view? Please elaborate. Answer. Out of the three categories, machinery is aiming for the global top group. Now, and your interpretation is correct. This is the group that has the products where Hitachi's brand name is recognized globally. Heat pump was mentioned. I'm sorry, compressors were mentioned. In terms of compressors, within our group, Siemens and Dresser, process gas compressor is one type. There is also air compressor for industry. This is also referred to as compressors. Both are recognized as being part of the top three. There are different numbers, so it is very difficult to come up with a specific ranking, but I believe that we are already in the top three. I mentioned alliance, and you alluded to the fact that perhaps there is no companies that can be acquired. However, I believe that inclusive of supporting industry, there are many companies that we can partner with. That is our view. So inclusive of collaboration with such companies, we will continue to work very hard so that we can become one of the top three players. Question. Let me confirm the following. Compressor is the strongest. Is that a correct understanding? Yes. A compressor has more positioning globally. For pumps, it is limited to certain areas. We are limiting the area in which we are competing for pumps. Thank you.
Question. This industrial products company, the internal sales and external sales, what's the breakdown between external and internal? Answer. Mid to small size, Hitachi Industrial Equipment Systems, the group internal sales is a little over 10%, and it's so mostly external sales. Now, industrial products company, business, perhaps 20 to 30% is the sales inside the group. Question. And the profit margin is about the same? Answer. Profit margin is not that different. Question. My second question, CCC and smart transformation project related matter, this products business and solution business, I think, have very different breakdown or content. So 70 days or 80 days, 77 days, maybe different. So what do you think about this? Please explain. And in this segment, there's products and solutions inside, which is a good combination, I think. But when you look at this as a Hitachi as a whole, how is this? Accounting structure, and if you could elaborate on this. Answer, CCC. You're right. Products, solutions have different format, and the period is different, or process is different. Now, EPC, projects, have low CCC or bad CCC. So we are trying to work on how to solve this and reviewing the contract to improve this. As you know, CCC is receiving of money and paying of money. How we can contain or put this under control is the key. Now in EPC, the advance money needs to be set at the contract time. And we also need to capture the pay per performance, or the pay be paid for the amount of work we did. Now, the biggest part in CCC is the inventory volume. So as we do, we need to reduce the lead time and how to synchronize the inventory and visualize the process. We often say that just by measuring our weight, we can start losing weight. So we need to see what's happening and how to capture the signs of improvement and move things forward. This is a steady, low-key activity, but we need to be steady. Question. So solution, about 100 days, and product, 40 to 50 days, and so overall 70 days. Is that the right breakdown? Answer, yes, that's right, image. Last question. 2018 overseas ratio, what is your forecast? Answer, 2018, we want to achieve 40%. Thank you.
Question. Thank you very much for your explanation. I have two questions. First question is the following. From A to E, you have shown the competitive landscape. Can you talk about the companies that you benchmark against? That's my first question. Second question is a confirmation. For 2018, revenues, 1 trillion is the target. Industrial products is 500 billion. So that means that the solution is also 500 billion, according to calculation. For 2014, that means the solution is 490 billion. Does that mean that the solution is not growing? That seems to be the case. Is this a correct understanding? If that is the case, why is it not growing? Answer. Regarding the competitive environment, in terms of comparison with the competitors, there is no other company that has exactly the same business model as Hitachi. Now, we are receiving, have come up with these numbers based on publicly available information. And we are trying to motivate ourselves, encourage ourselves further internally. But it's not apples to apples comparison. And it could be misunderstood if company names are given. So we will refrain from stating the names of the companies on this page. Now, regarding 2018 revenues, the target is 1 trillion yen. Components is 500 billion, and solutions are 500 billion. That is the breakdown. However, inside these numbers, we are considering further growth than these numbers. But nevertheless, you must ask why this is the case. EPC selection process is underway currently, especially for Middle East projects. There is a difference in culture compared to Japan. Operation is difficult. Taking all these factors into consideration, currently we have identified the 1 trillion target.
Any other questions? The person in the front row. Question. Just one question. Components, industrial products, component. Looking at this table, fiscal year 14 result is 300 billion and operating income is 20 billion yen for fiscal year 2014. And so 500 billion for fiscal year 18 and 50 billion operating income. Now, in the year just ended, driver and power supply and transmission, and what is the breakdown of the 300 billion and how do you plan to increase this? So on an annualized basis, it doesn't seem like a big increase in fiscal year 15, so maybe 60, 70 billion increase in the remaining years. So please break down the number. Answer. So in today's presentation, infrastructure systems group, this is the extension of the infrastructure systems group. So 300 billion yen, this graph that seems like 300 billion yen, this includes the former, does not include the former power. It does not include power. It was included in 2015 budget. An industrial products company was launched in May, so it's a bit complex. So industrial products companies, starting point, we have 10% more, which is the products that come from power. About 320 billion is the correct image. So we will grow from there. About less than half is machinery, 45% or so. And about one quarter, one fourth to 30% is drive automation. And the remainder is the power supply and power transmission and other businesses, miscellaneous businesses. So that's the breakdown. So 2018, 500 billion. The breakdown will not change much? Answer. The composition is also a part of our thinking under our strategy. Question. So you will see a significant growth. Compressors and pumps. So you will do the screening. So this side may not grow that much. How do you plan to grow this part? Compressors and products in the next 3 years, industrial products. Answer. I did not understand your question well. Question. This compressor and pump, this area, do you plan to grow this business as well? On the other hand, oil and gas and you're receiving the deals on a selected basis. So the main play, mainstay, compressors, can you grow this business? That's my question. Answer. So I said selective screening of the projects. This is EPC. For products, industrial products, so it's traditional plus alpha, traditional level plus alpha, are compressors and pumps. From a global perspective, we are in the large size category. And therefore, we are a niche. We're a niche product. Oil and gas, even if oil and gas is a bit weak, we have other areas like water. So that's how we think of our business. So we do not think this business will shrink. Question. Thank you.
We can take one more question. Question. Now, in terms of products, for 2018, 500 billion is a revenue, and you're hoping to increase this further down the road. For domestic and overseas, what is the breakdown? How is it going to change? And what about the allocation of human resources between Japan and overseas? In terms of production, please elaborate the specific numbers. For 2018, the balance is something that we will be deciding from now on. The overall global ratio must be disclosed, but I would say that 40% is a good guideline. It is a target for us. But the product industry has shown in various products. There are different business areas, and 95% are already global business. Therefore, as a group, the global ratio is not only the indicator that we are taking into consideration to improve the business, because depending on the product and areas, the appropriate global ratio will differ. Question. I didn't ask my question right. I would like to know the global and the production, sales and production ratio in terms of global. Answer. Global ratio and global production ratio. There is a disconnect between the two. It is out of balance because the Japanese production is more prevalent, is higher. I hope I have been able to answer your question. Question, how is that going to change over time? Answer, this is something that will be decided from business to business, and I don't have a number to represent the whole group. But we would like to grow these businesses to a certain market size. And once we obtain our market share, the production decision will be made. There are some businesses that are poised to go that route. There are others that are not. And there are some products that should have concentrated, centralized production. So it's very difficult to generalize and answer your question. Now, compressor is a good case in point. For turbines, it's very similar. Very high engineering level, high technology levels are required to manufacture these products. In terms of setting up plants, there is a constraint. Currently, what we are doing is the following. We are considering the possibility of doing engineering work overseas. In Philippines, we have a group already in place. And engineer is a special profession in the Philippines. And we have established a group comprising these engineers. Design work is underway. That is the first step. Beyond that, it will depend on the request from our customers. We will have to respond to the customer needs. From Saudi Arabia, a compressor maintenance may be requested to be done in Saudi Arabia. We will have to respond to that. And in Saudi Arabia, we have established a company that can provide maintenance work. So producing overseas may be far into the future, but deployment of our business overseas are making progress. Measures have been implemented accordingly. With this, we would like to bring the infrastructure system business explanation to a close. Thank you.